So today we are going to talk about 3D map as designing and analysis tool. The essence of map making is to represent our reality, our environment, in generally a flat surface. This is not a new concern to humankind. For example, 1400 years before Christ, people from Nippur and ancient civilization already tried to represent their environment on clay tablets. The paradigm they used is still used today, but of course we don't use clay tablet anymore, we use paper now, but still we represent the urban environment on flat surface, on paper. So here you have a map of London that said accurate. This is quite nice, you can see the layout of the city, you can see the rivers, but of course there is some information you will miss here. For example, you cannot zoom in a building, and you cannot know the height of the buildings as well. Some people try to overcome this limitation by simply representing different perspectives, still on a flat surface. Here is a map of Basel where we can see the height of the building, but here, what do you miss? The information behind those buildings. So no matter the way we choose, as long as we represent in 2D, we lose information. Well, the fact is, our reality is 3D. We live in a 3D space. So of course, if you want to represent that 3D space in 2D space, we lose information. So the point of 3D mapping is to be able to keep all the information we need and take advantage of it. Of course, we have to leave something. The same way we left clay tablets for paper, we'll leave paper for computer this time. And we can do a lot of things with computers. For example, you can zoom in the model, you can zoom out, you can rotate, you can displace, you can choose the point of view you want. And the good thing in this, it's all about visualization so far, but moreover, you can perform very advanced analysis thanks to computers. So to make a 3D map, you will have to model your environment, your reality. Let's say, for example, we have this building of BK, the architecture building where we are right now. You want to make a model of it. Basically, you have three ways to do. The first one is to build it from scratch. You see the building, you know how it looks like. You use a modeler on your computer, and you simply manually build this model similar to this. It will take you a lot of time, but you can make it really nice. The second way is to start data that we already have. As I said earlier, we have been using 2D maps for millennia already. So we have a lot of them. One thing we can do with them is to get the layout of the footprints and simply extrude that footprint to obtain the height information that's missing to the 2D to become 3D. But here, the representation we will have is simplified. So we miss some information, for example, we don't have the roofs. And finally, the last way we could use is to measure that reality we want to represent. To do so, nowadays we have 3D scanners that can be on flying tools, that like a drone, for example, or a helicopter, that could be on cars to go around the building and acquire what we call 3D point cloud. That is a 3D measurement of that building. Of course, you can see through because it's not a structured information, but that's something you can use to make a more advanced model. That's it.